This is a series of fire behavior videos with associated fuel moisture and weather information. Use these resources to identify the fuel models. Dead fuel moistures are given as categories: very low, low, moderate, and high. Herbaceous and woody fuel moistures are also categorized as very low, low, moderate, and high, and are often estimated based on the season. For this first example, we'll walk through the steps that you'll be needing to take for the other examples that are later in the video. It's recommended that you write this information down on a piece of paper so that you can refer to it as you are trying to select your fuel model.
I'm at a patrol back, just be back here patrolling. Copy.
The first step is to determine what the primary fire carrier is. Next, select whether this is a dry climate or a humid climate. Is the expected fire behavior low, moderate, or high? Now you can compare your fire behavior to the fuel model comparison graph. The graph that you select will depend on the fire behavior that you are seeing. If you have lower rates of spread and lower fire behavior, you'd want to choose a figure like this that has those values spread out. Just make sure you're paying attention to what the values on that y-axis are. If you have fire behavior that is higher, like we have here with higher rates of spread and higher flame lengths, then you would choose a figure like this where you can see that information still. Remember that each point of these fuel models represents the fire behavior at wind speeds of 1 through 10 in this case, where you have those 10 dots along this vertical line. If we're seeing a rate of spread of 80 chains per hour and flame lengths of 8 feet, and we know that our winds were 5 to 8 miles per hour, then you can see that we have two fuel models that look like they might be possible choices for our area. Look up each likely fuel model in GTR 153. Select the fuel model that best represents the flame lengths under the given weather and fuel moisture conditions. Which fuel model is the best fit for the observed rate of spread? In this case, the answer is GR2 or 102, low load, dry climate grass. Observed fire behavior was slightly higher than was showing in the GR2 fuel model, but it was the closest fit. Complete the following scenarios using the same steps just demonstrated. If you select a different fuel model than what's given, try working backward from the answer to see why it was selected. In this example, GR2, or low load dry climate grass, represents the rate of spread and flame length well, but this is a complex site. TL8, or long needle litter, may work equally well depending on your objectives. In this example, neither fuel model fully estimates fire behavior, yet both match at least some part of the fire behavior. Since we normally look at a range of inputs and fire behavior over, say, a burn period, to select a fuel model, we often look at more than one fuel model to verify that we can predict fire behavior throughout that time. The take-home message here is to always consider a variety of fuel models. And remember, fire modeling is really a science and an art. Sometimes there is no right answer, just information that you can use to make the best possible management decisions, documenting your assumptions along the way.
Yeah. Welcome to California.